real stake in this, Larry. Better be cool.
Pursuit of 211 suspects driving a tan four-wheel drive north on Park Drive.
Four surface streets over the top of that hill. Call dispatch. Tell them we lost them.
4 Adam 30 lost 211 suspects.
Pigeon's leg band. This road's been swept this morning. This could have been dropped by a witness. Or one of the suspects.
Those numbers on it mean anything?
Yeah. And I have a friend who can tell us exactly what.
Well, why don't you check it out? The detectives are up to their necks.
Okay. Captain, we haven't seen anything planned with this kind of detail in years. Phony detour, explosives, four-wheel drive for the getaway.
Trust me, Hooker. I'll be here and I'll make sure nothing's overlooked, okay?
I feel better already.
Now look, there's a storm drain near my house. I'll dump the bag in there. It'll never turn up.
No, Larry. The bag goes back to where you've been hiding it, so it's not connected with us. Then I'll put together another score, because you cost us this one.
Carl, I can't risk another one. We were lucky this time.
It wasn't luck, you punk. It was planning.
Linda, I'll handle this. Now, Larry, we're going again. You go back inside that armored car yard the same way. And this time you do a better job of hooking up those explosives, or I pick up the phone and you find yourself back on the inside. You understand?
Down, will you, Hooker? I got three nuns in there feeding their babies.
What?
Don't be shocked. You've probably got some King's Tumblers and Fantails feeding the babies, too. When Hank's not rolling around in their cars, he's breeding pigeons. Hank Carmichael. My partner, Vince Romano.
It's quite a place you got here, Hank.
Yeah, I got my home, my work, my hobby all rolled into one. I checked on that leg band registry number you asked me about, Hooker. Belongs to Larry Coates. I've seen him and his kid sister over at the Pigeon Exchange a couple of times. Kid's cute, really into birds. Him, I don't know. You ask me, he's a little on the twitchy side.
I owe you, Hank.
I'm gonna call you Star Chaser. You're gonna be the fastest racing homer in the valley. We're gonna train every day.
Hiya, Katie. How's the Pride and Joy doing?
That bag's full of trouble for us, isn't it, Larry? I saw those two people who picked you up this morning.
You're gonna have to forget you saw them or this bag.
What happened, Larry? Everything was so neat. The birds, the house, you working.
Sorry, Katie.
Don't make us get messed up again, Larry. Please.
It was a fluke. Paul spotted me a few weeks ago when I was scouting the score.
I knew him in prison. He knows our secret. Now, if I don't help him, he'll turn me in. Just a few days, Katie. And then they'll be gone and everything will be okay again.
Small flock of them when I was a kid.
Yeah? Well, you wouldn't feel that way about them if you'd spent a whole summer scrubbing park statues like I did in South Philly.
Must have been for the birds. Scoop is around back.
Is long gone.
Well, hello.
I'm Sergeant Hooker. You can put your hands down. What's your name?
Katie. Katie Coates.
Katie? Was that your brother Larry who just left?
Where are your parents?
My folks died 2 years ago.
I'm sorry. We want to talk to your brother. Where was he going?
Where does he work? Katie, if you don't tell me what I want to know, we're going to have to take you down to the precinct. We'll wait while you bring him down and feed him if you want. I'll bet you're a mumbler. That's what they call you if you have more to say to your pigeons than the people.
How do you know that?
Sometimes mumblers grow up and become cops. We'll feed them together. Parents are dead.
That's right. I told you that already.
Really?
Where'd you get that?
Your house. That's your father and mother?
I don't know who those people are.
Sorry, I must have made a mistake. I'll just take it right back.
Just... No, don't!
Well, now that that's settled. You said that your parents died in a traffic accident.
They did.
But you said it happened here, on a freeway. It didn't. There's no record of a Mr. and Mrs. Coates dying in a freeway accident. Unless your parents' name is different from yours. Or unless your name isn't Katie Coates.
It is! They are all, I don't know, you're confusing me.
I'm sorry, Katie. I don't want to scare you or confuse you. I just got to do my job. And the hard part of my job isn't catching the bad guy. It's protecting innocent people. And your brother may have hurt some innocent people. He may be planning to hurt some others. You don't want that to happen, do you? Good. Now, will you help me find your brother? Totally committed to protecting her brother.
Alan Jacobs came up with zip for any kind of history on either one of them before they rented that house a year ago.
This might lead somewhere. I think it's Katie's mother and father. There's a photographer's stamp on the back. Salt Lake City.
It was milk and cookies and hours of girl talk. Katie's a super kid and really bright for her age. And fun. We both got the giggles.
Just girl talk?
Sorry, Hooker. Nothing else that you wanted to know.
Well, this should help open her up. Came in last night from Utah. It answers a lot of questions about Katie.
She's up in her coop, crazy about those birds.
It's easy to understand why. That little girl deserves all the help we can give her. Good morning.
Morning.
Stacy tells me that you were up hours ago.
I just like to spend as much time as I can with my birds.
Katie. This came in from Salt Lake City this morning. It says your real family name is Porter, and that when your brother was serving time for burglary,
Your parents were killed in an automobile accident. And it also says that you ran away from a foster home you were in several times, and that when your brother was paroled, they wouldn't let you live with him in his custody. Is that when you and your brother ran away and came out here?
Look, I know what you think about Larry with prison and all. But he's not like that. I love him a lot. And he loves me. I'm not going to tell you anything about Larry, Sergeant. So I guess I'm going to that juvenile hall place.
Well, we'll see. But if you do, it won't be because you wouldn't tell me about your brother.
Well, she's ready to work tonight. We'll put her at Ward Zahmert's car. Pretty nervous over there. Someone planted explosives on one of their cars. It sure wouldn't have happened if our dogs were on duty.
You're right about that. Didn't happen while our dogs were there.
You guys look around. I'll go find Hank.
Right.
That's impossible, Hooker.
Station and my birds take up all my time. I got no room for a kid.
Hank, after all these years, first time I've been in here. I gotta tell you, looking around, it tells me one thing. Lonely guy lives here. All I'm asking you to do is to move out some of this stuff and let in a girl who could really use your help. It'll do you both some good.
It's just not that simple, Hooker.
Forget simple, Hank. What's simple about the way you run your life and your business from that chair? I'll tell you what's simple. Katie, her problem, that's simple. Either I find her a place to stay, or I watch her being warehoused into some place that could harm her.
Kids in school, what do I know about that?
Huh? You know about people. Hey, Katie is special, and she needs someone right now. If you can't do more, just let her stay here this afternoon while I find her some other place.
Morning, Hank.
Katie Coates. This is Hank Carmichael. Two of you must know each other from the pigeon exchange.
It's Lightning. Where did you find him?
I saw him just lying up on top of the coop.
I took him out for a run 3 days ago, and he never made it back.
He's lost some feathers. Looks like he's been hit by a hawk.
Oh, Lightning. He's my best homer. He's gonna need a lot of rest and quiet to mend.
There's no way he's gonna rest at your coop. It's way too busy. My coop would be perfect. Besides, I'd like you to see my birds. Yours are terrific.
Well, thanks. I'd like that. Well, what do you say we jump into the truck and take this guy right on over there?
Let me give you a hand. Katie, Vince and I are gonna spend every minute we can trying to find you a place to stay. There is no way that you're gonna spend the night in juvenile hall.
Katie, I got a small bedroom buried under a pile of books back there somewhere. You want to help me dig it out? You're welcome to crash here for a few days.
Really?
What a good idea.
I'll notify child welfare. Child mumblers.
Thank you.
The old timers catch these weekend guard shifts. Now this one's knotted out in front of the security office TV.
Let's do it.
Larry, it's only gonna take a dime to put you back in the slammer and your kid sister back wherever they put orphans these days.
Inside, make sure everything looks like it's been untouched.
Let's just split.
You know, being sloppy will get you to the same place that my dime will. If they find this stuff missing, we'll just let them think the day crew's been lifting it.
Emergency crew.
God, why did you do that?
He did it because it was necessary. Carl!
Be quiet. Be quiet.
All right. Come on. We're still all right. We'll leave him somewhere outside the fence. They'll find him in the morning. With the gate locked and the dogs loose, it'll look like he got it when he surprised somebody trying to break in. Come on, Larry, give me a hand.
4 out of 30. 4 out of 30. Citizen reports hearing shots fired in the vicinity of Espo's Construction Company. 1080 South Central. 4 out of 30. Handle the call. Code 3.
Put a roger on that.
4 out of 30. Roger.
Shoes. This man has been dragged out here. Remember that phony armored car detour? I wonder if anything's missing in there.
You could steal a hard hat and a road clothes sign from almost any construction site in town, Hooker.
Or from where they won't be missed.
I almost violated a squadron commandment. Thou shalt not reject a Hooker suggestion. When the day shift comes on, I'll have the yard inventory. And I'm getting an employees list coming from Ward's armored car. Sure use a lead on Larry Coates.
You can count on one thing, Jacobs. It's there, like the scuff on the back of his shoes. If you look long enough and hard enough, you'll see it. Stacy, anything come in yet on the armored car ammo?
Yes.
Utah?
2 years ago, 2 armored car robberies in Salt Lake City with MOs like the attempt here yesterday. They used explosives.
Huh. They nail anyone behind the robberies?
But a few weeks after the last one, a guy blew himself up assembling a bomb in his garage. Same type used in the robberies. Lab said the bomb was gimmick. He was burned by his partners.
Sergeant Hooker, can we speak privately?
Yeah. See that Jacobs gets a copy of it.
I respect your feelings, Sergeant. But I have no intention of losing my job over Katie Coates. After your phone call, I rushed right over to meet Mr. Carmichael. You know he'd be totally unsuitable as a guardian in this situation.
Why? Because he's a warm, loving person who shares Katie's interests? Or because he's lonely himself and we can actually help two human beings by bringing them together? Or is it his wheelchair?
I don't make the rules, Hooker.
No, but you're a professional. And you care, and you know that Katie's only guilty of loving her brother. Considering that, isn't Hank a better alternative than juvenile hall?
The minute my supervisor sees my report.
Then delay it. Lose it. You know that Katie deserves a break.
Forget it, kid. I took every shortcut I know getting here. There's no way that bird could have beat us this time.
Wowee, he's here, Hank.
I don't believe it. That's the third time he's beat us here from my coop. He might even be faster than Lightning. By the way, how is Lightning? How's he doing?
He seemed to be much better this morning. I better make sure he has enough food.
Don't scream, Katie, it's me.
Oh, are you all right, Larry? I've been so worried.
I'm okay. I've only got a minute, so listen. We've got to run away again. I'll be back to get you at 5 o'clock. Can you be here?
Larry, I don't want to run anymore. The birds in the house, maybe there's another way. Sergeant Hooker, the cop who came...
Katie, you don't understand. I'm caught in the middle. We both are. One phone call from Carl and it's jail time in Utah, and you go back to another foster home. Look, babe, I'll do this last one with Carl, and then we'll take the money and go someplace new.
Beep, beep. Katie! Come on, let's go!
That's Hank. He's a real nice guy, Larry. I just wish you could get to know him.
5 o'clock, Katie.
Sure, it's the guy that delivers and picks up the guard dogs.
I'll bet you that guard dog protection outfit services Ward's armored cars as well.
Well, let's find out.
Thank you.
Yeah. 30, now northbound in the riverbed.
It's getting harder and harder to think of Larry Coates as Katie's brother.
I'm sorry, Hooker. The paperwork just wouldn't stay lost. Got to bring Katie in.
Look, wait a minute. You don't have to do that. I mean...
Please, Hooker. For Katie's sake, don't prolong this. She's not going to juvenile hall. I've arranged for a temporary foster home, and I've told Mr. Carmichael how to appeal his status.
Miss Campbell will push. I'll see the judge. Well, there's a good chance you could be back here by tomorrow. That is, if you want to.
Sure.
Katie, please try to understand. A man was killed, perhaps by the people your brother's involved with.
Larry wouldn't be part of killing anyone. He couldn't.
Come here. Come here. Sit down. Sweetheart, you know what happens to a renegade pigeon. They disrupt the coop, starts to hurt the other birds, and no matter how much you love that pigeon, you got to do something to stop it from destroying the others. I know it isn't easy, but you got to help me stop Larry from doing something worse than he's already done.
I won't tell him, Larry. I can't. But thanks for being nice and trying for me, Sergeant Hooker.
Hi, baby.
Larry was the way past the guard dogs at the armored car and at the construction company.
We've got an APB out on him. He had been hiding at the kennel. We found his motorcycle nearby, but he won't stay hidden long.
Hooker, here's an answer to the follow-up call you made to Salt Lake. Carl Hines, Larry's cellmate, has an explosives background, but Salt Lake could never get enough on him to tie him into the armored car robbers. Linda Teller, his girlfriend, she's been locked up for armed robbery, too.
Sounds like all the players.
When Larry gets home, Lightning, we're going away. And you're going back to Hank where you can get all better.
All right, where is it?
Hey, Carl, let me have that cash now, and I'll get you the bag.
Get your share after we hit the truck.
Carl, you can't be serious. The cops know about me. I told you.
We're very serious, Larry. Now just be a good boy and do what Carl asked.
The cops must know by now. If we make a move on that armored truck, we're dead.
Not the way I've worked it out, Buster. Now, we follow the plan. Outside the amusement park, we wait at Wilson Road. If the cops have figured it out, they'll have taken the charges off the truck. If not, we blow it.
No, it's crazy. It's too risky.
You loser. You never had a choice. How far do you think we'd let you go with the kind of cold feet you've got?
Let's get the stuff out, Larry.
Go to Hank.
Where is it, Larry? I'm not going to tell you.
Stop it! Leave him alone!
It's all right, Katie.
No, it's not all right, Katie. Now, if you want to save your brother, you tell me where that bag is he hides in here.
Don't tell him. I was crazy. I should have run the minute you spotted me.
Too late now, kid. You and your sister are coming along, or you're staying here, dead.
You've got 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2.
It's in the feed bin.
Item 30, go ahead, Stacy.
We just received a call from Sarah Campbell. Katie ran away from her foster home 2 hours ago. She checked their house, and she didn't go back to her birds.
There's only one place she could go. To Hank's.
Guys, what's happening?
Have you seen Katie?
No, not since she left with the social worker. Why?
Hank, isn't that one of your pigeons, the bird that was hurt?
Yeah, it's Lightning.
Give me your Lightning.
Katie had him.
Come here, Lightning. Come here, baby. There's a note. It's from Katie. Armored car robbery on Wilson Road near amusement park.
Let's contact Ward's. Must be one of their trucks.
W90 to 4 out of 30.
Go 90.
Jacobs confirms that Ward's has an armored car that just left its pickup at the amusement park.
Thanks, Stacy. That's our target. We're on our way.
Like I said, nothing around that looks like trouble. I've been a real turkey, Katie.
Maybe it'll be all right. How touching.
This time, those charges, they better be on right.
Cops! Run, Katie, run! Get out of here!
can take care of Larry. You go get them.
We'll call the paramedics.
We're item 30, requesting an RA unit. Man down at the Wilson Road entrance to the amusement park.
I didn't understand what you were warning me about.
No, Katie. I'm the one who made all the mistakes.
Well, that's the understatement of the year.
Let's just hope it's the last of your mistakes. And the beginning of something a whole lot better for Katie. Larry?
Better. He'll be out of the hospital soon, and a lawyer friend of Hank's is going to handle his case.
Isn't that great?
A buddy of mine from the Pigeon Breeders Association. He says because of the circumstances, the judge may give Larry some special consideration.
That's the toughest judge I've ever dealt with. But Hooker's very moving deposition did the trick. Hank's been granted temporary guardianship of Katie.
All right.
All these good things because of you, Hooker.
No, sweetheart, really because of you.